So oftentimes, if we're working on this and on a project like this, that might be subject to FOIL because maybe a reporter wants to know. If a person reaches out to my office and says, I'm being evicted by my landlord, or I'm a victim of domestic violence, we do not share that. That is completely protected and it is privileged. So a lot of things we share, my schedule, we draw the line on my schedule on where I went to dinner with my wife. You can still find out I went to dinner with my wife on Friday night, but we try to draw the line there too. So I believe in openness, so I think you are number four.
So I'm more familiar with NYC's open data, which was an initiative that basically normalized the data so you can actually ingest it more programmatically. Bills, not just bills, but sort of like, yeah, basically, you know, real estate bills, things of that nature, all that stuff. Now, what you're talking about is pretty much legislative type data. Am I understanding that correctly? And it's not necessarily cleaned up in any way that's machine readable right now, correct?
So there's the open data platform. Within the open data platform, there's all sorts of treasure troves. So there's the tax data, there's ACRIS data, which is property data. Then we have the city record, which is now in open data, but what they do is they take all that information that I've showed you as examples, and they paste it into a text field on their backend, which is a Microsoft.NET backend, and they don't normalize the data going in. So as they say, garbage in, garbage out, unless you've got some folks who have natural language processing abilities and can save the person who's been doing the same thing for 30 years of copy it from here and paste it to there and let them continue to do their piece but put in a connector in between. So there's that. And then in addition to the city record notices, there's other data which I care about, which is legislation. I would really love to use legal rule ML so that we could mark up legislation and laws as they pass so that computers can interpret it, because every day the government is passing tens or hundreds of laws. And I already told you that it's Hammurabi already told us, it's on a stone block somewhere. So if you're not keeping track of it, how are you going to do something about it? So there's that. I also put the budget online. And so you can see $84 billion, give or take, but most folks don't have the ability to go through it and see how much of that is being spent on them. You have a follow-up?
The follow-up really is then, so in order to process this into something more machine usable, by from a developer, I don't take raw PDF or raw text. I need to go to machine learning and other such things. These are infrastructures that need to be built up, and honestly, they cost money. How is the intention to pay for it, or is this going to be equivalent to an fourth estate type issue where they have to go hat in hand to make sure that they are getting subscribers or whatever to make sure that they are watching the government and doing and making sure it's doing the right thing?
So the question is this government going to do this ourselves, or is government asking for a fourth estate project of like the press holding us in check, or are we asking for something for free? I'm more of an activist, so I'm still an activist in government. So the city record site, such as it is an initial rollout. My power as a legislator is budgetary and legislative, so I could say I want you to spend more money on this project and hire a vendor to do this for you. At the same time, and I can do that, but I've tried, and they're going slowly and incrementally, and I'd like to move faster. The other piece is I'm kind of a hacker by training, and by hacker I'm not black hat, it's white hat. I like to take government data and use it to tell stories and force change. So I honestly don't think government can do the job, and I don't think a vendor can do as good a job as a bunch of folks at a hackathon. I think one of the more frustrating things I see over and over again in government is waste and corruption. So go back to 2007, there's this voter file of all the people registered in the state of New York. It had 12 million people in it. I had two different copies of the database. One of them had 10 million records in it. And so I asked what happened to 2 million people, and they said, well, we didn't want the database to get too big, so we dropped 2 million records. And so I tried to explain to them that there's this thing called indexing, and that a 12 million record database isn't actually big, and that you can just mark things properly and index properly. And so I realized people needed to be able to verify their voter registration. So I wrote the code. It was 100 lines of code. I actually taught myself MySQL, PHP to build it, because those were the tools I needed, and launched it. I offered the 100 lines of code to the state of New York. They paid a vendor $250,000 to build the same system. It didn't work on their day of launch. So then I sent them my code again and said, do you just want to put my site up? And funny enough, they're still using the same front end as I designed versus the vendor's new front end. So I guess it's just over and over again, I see free and open source projects launch, offer a service, and then folks decide to pay a vendor to do something that's already available. So it's frustrating to me. I have two bills. One would require the city to consider free and open source software anytime we're acquiring new software, especially roll your own software. The other one is, it was originally called something else, Civic Commons, which was championed by Code for America, but now it would just require the city to have a GitHub repo so you could actually see the tools we have, and city employees could actually see, huh, I need something to edit photos. I wonder what we have. Oh, look, there's a link from our GitHub repo to go use GIMP. That's a good tool. Oh, maybe I can get trained on that, and instead of spending God knows how much on Adobe, we could actually just use free and open source tools. And forgive me for using Microsoft here. I do have LibreOffice installed on my computer. How many more questions can I take, Ralph?
Should we, one more question, each?
Yeah, we have time.
We have time?
Okay.
We have time.
So I see this gentleman and that gentleman and that young lady.
I'm curious how your colleagues in City Council view the work you're doing and your thoughts on where you want to take it.
I went to the Bronx High School of Science, and those were the only 4 years of my life I didn't get picked on for being a nerd.
I think the follow-up unrelated is, but it's really a follow-up to that. Is there the opportunity for City Council to not necessarily fund hackathons, but to really incentivize the hackathons that you're talking about, to get people to come and do the things that you're describing?
So ostensibly we have an $84 billion budget, and typically what would happen with this kind of idea, just to go into the other example, so I have this great idea, let me give another example. I have this great idea, it's called Open 311. Why should I have to call a phone number or use the city's really broken app? Has anyone tried to use the city's broken app?
No.
It's very broken. The GPS system is not intuitive, it's often wrong, and I don't know if that's because Android is reporting it wrong, because it seems to work well on Google Maps, but it doesn't seem to work well on the 3-in-1 API, and so why should I have to use that? And so Open 3-in-1 would allow people to do it through an open API. So we put it out to contract, and we have one of the largest 3-in-1s in the country, if not the world. And so two vendors spent the past 4 years killing each other, Microsoft and SQL. SQL has a product called Siebel, that's their CRM. Microsoft has Dynamics. And so this has had an RFP issued, contract awarded, lawsuit, RFP reissued, contract awarded, lawsuit, RFP issued, contract awarded, now we finally have it. So it's now IBM Watson as the back-end search, because why would anyone need solar? When we can use Watson to do something different than solar. So I guess one of the concerns I just have is I can ask DCAS to bring somebody in, but I'm concerned about the folks showing up with the money to do something that they will get for IBM and Microsoft versus Oracle, when we might be able to build an open source tool as a community. And whether it's this data that needs to be eaten and used to empower folks, I guess I don't trust government to do a good job. And if we did do a good job, we would be giving it to a vendor who would lock up the data in whatever way they could anyway. And so, as I saw on the open law issue of them writing an RFP, I guess it's something I'm open to. It's something I'd be interested in working with folks in the community on. I guess the only thing is I wouldn't want to write the RFP so that one person in this room could get the contract and another person couldn't, but I would be interested in writing the RFP so that it would require a free and open source software alternative, so whatever we build has to be available for every other municipality in the country and on the planet.
Yeah.
Thank you. Last two, yeah.
What's your position on the New York Constitutional Convention?
The question is, what is my position on the Constitutional Convention? Who here knows about the Constitutional Convention? Okay, two. In 2017, okay, in our code for operating the state of New York, there is a question that it has to come to the ballot every 20 years. So it's a reset mechanism. Every 20 years, unless we vote against it, the code wants to reset itself. So we have an opportunity this year to decide if we think New York State is running well. And if New York State is running well and the source code is great, then let's stick with version 1921. No, it wasn't amended in 94. Thank you. So if we want to stay with the 1921 version of code, or would we like to open it up and have a convention convene people to rewrite it? And so there is an opportunity to do something with that when you take the Constitution out of the hands of elected officials. Like term limits, which we have in the city but we don't have in the state, so people don't stay there forever. We could do something like having campaign finance on a state level. We could protect something which isn't protected in New York, which is a woman's right to choose. Because if the federal government chooses to remove those protections would trickle down here. We could also give you a right to light and air and fresh water. So I think there is a lot that we could do with a constitutional convention at a time that we feel that government is broken, and even have a chance to create a right for people to have input in government and have their input considered. So I am in favor of a constitutional convention and urge you to vote yes in November 2017. Follow-up question.
How would you feel about being replaced by a bot which would execute free open source open contracts, which would have the consent of the governed of the individual and would perform to the satisfaction of the public? Why do we need a human being doing the job?
So the question is, would I support report replacing myself with a robot? So first question answer is, the kids at Bronx Science already did that. I went there for a ribbon cutting, and their robotics team, all women, the FE Maidens. Anyone know what that stands for? FE. The Iron Maidens. The Iron Maidens made a ribbon cutting robot. So essentially, they took that's one of the few things elected officials do. Quick answer is, a lot of jurisdictions don't have 311. 311 is supposed to be the killer app. Before 311, there's blue pages and the white pages. White pages are these things that used to be delivered to everyone's home and happens outside of New York City. And so you would have to figure out which agency was the right agency to call when something was wrong. Now we have 311. We take it for granted here in New York City. Anyone here never called 311? Okay, that's. Please use it. It's a way. If 311 worked, I'd be out of a job. I spend most of my time trying to fix systemic problems in government. That being said, we can have a drink and talk about Isaac Asimov and iRobot and the series and how far he gets in terms of rule by computers. And one of the questions that Asimov actually gets to is, why do the computers end up having inefficiencies? And the postulation of whether or not the computers created inefficiencies because the humans that were being governed were frail. But that being said, I would like to keep my job, but I'd like to replace as much of my job as possible with computers. And you can talk to my staff because we run my office on Agile, we use Trello, we are investing in CiviCRM. We've actually invested about $40,000 so far into CiviCRM, and I do have small grants available in government offices, and almost every elected official does, and I try to spend them on free and open source products. So I know $20,000 may not be a lot for an open source product, but with Donald Lobo, who's excellent, they've been able to make those dollars stretch. Last question.
So I guess I wanted to ask about the convention of public funding
democracy. It seems to me what you're alluding to is that in order to have effective democracy, you need an educated or properly informed populace that's engaged, and maybe a cultural dynamic where people actually care about or understand how to use their local government. So it's all well and good to tell people you should exercise your civic duty, but the reality is most people don't have the bandwidth. So accepting that, and then talking about the various solutions that we're talking about today, how do you kind of see a bridge between the reality?
Sure. So I've got some legislation just along the lines of what some of the gentlemen were talking about. Oh, sorry. The question, as I said, government is broken, but there's a bandwidth problem, and it's hard to really get involved. So how do we bridge that gap? So again, I can legislate, require government to do certain things. I actually prefer to legislate that government do things than the private sector do things. I'm a little bit hands-off, so unless you're poisoning children, or doing something bad to the marketplace, I try to leave the private market alone and try to stay away from overregulation there. So I focus on government regulation. So I'm kind of out here just trying to sound the alarm and mobilize folks. But ultimately, and we're working on legislation to this point, but whether or not a government using 19th century procurement models can build what I want. So if we do this hackathon on this city record, we can do something that I want. I'm a New Yorker. All I care, get to work, get home, go to where I'm gonna hang out with my friends, get home. I care about schools, if my kid's in school, but I only care about the school on my block. And so I just want to be able to answer a couple of questions about what I care about on an Android app. And I wanna be able to put in my home, my destination, maybe some other key interests, where I work, maybe where else I go to the gym, things like that. And I only want to get notifications about the things that are relevant to me. Do I care about them redoing the streets? No. Do I care about them doing the street in front of my house? Yes. I want to make sure I make other plans. If they're doing construction aside across the street from my house, I want to know if there's an after-hours variance and if they're going to wake me up on a weekend because I can go out of town that weekend. I want to know if my commute's going to be delayed because they're doing work on the subways. And so I think that if folks had that type of tool, and if we took the city record and really created a tool where folks had I call it government 3.0, because 2.0 means you can go back and forth. 3.0 means it's actually location aware and aware of where I am and what I care about. And if Google can tell me, anyone using Google Now yet? Mm-hmm. So that's really creepy, because when I walk past Duane Reade, it tells me what's on sale. It tries to get me to walk into that Duane Reade. And so if I can do that for Duane Reade, why can't government do that for the things I care about? So that's what I'm hoping the killer app is. There's a lot of, even if we have a vendor and things like that, there's a lot of folks who have been in government for their entire careers. And I have tremendous respect for them. And anyone who's ever joined a large corporation, you tend to run into institutional inertia, where folks do things because that's how they've been doing it for the past 10, 30 years. Institutional inertia can creep up on you even in year 3 of being a council member or what have you, where you ask somebody, why are you doing this? It's not working. And they say, well, that's what we've been doing for the past 3 years. And unless you're in an agile place where you're doing retrospectives and you say, this is broken, we should stop, it continues. So ultimately, there's one piece, which is just management. If the mayor had an agile management system, I think things might change. But otherwise, we can put external pressure and we can build the tools that we need using the data that we can get our hands on until we can do it. So there's 5 minutes before the next speaker, so I don't want to go over time. I see at least one hand. I am not going anywhere too quickly. For those who came in late, first Friday of every month, 8 a.m. to 10 a.m., meet with constituents. If you live between 54th and 100th, Lexington or 2nd to the East River or Roosevelt Island, I work for you. I also do brainstorming with Ben. I give a pass to folk like Ralph or others who are tech folks who are interested in tackling some of these problems with me, and I'm happy to talk to you and help you get more involved. You can also tweet me at Ben Kallos. You can email me at bkallos@benkallos.com. That is subject to FOIL. Reporters will ask for it and read it and want to know why you're talking to me, especially if you're a big corporation or a small corporation, especially if you do business with the city. But ultimately, I work for you. I work for you for the next 9 months and 24 days. I'm hoping my contract gets renewed. I'm hoping to have your support, and I'm hoping that we can upgrade government together. Thank you.